Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. Let's see if I can switch this over. Man, it has gotten, see if I can make that brighter. All right, that's a little better. All right, so I was going through YouTube comments today. I'm behind about a week, and I made it to, let's see if I can share one with you. I think this is the one I'll share with you. So this one right here, it says, let's see, I got to move something out of my way. Ben, I have a question about building your $900 cash cow cart. I know this cart is basic. Can things be added to the cart? Well, it's not that basic. It has a water system. It has the full-size commercial steam table, a bread box, enclosed propane tank holder for two propane tanks, just like a big dog or a cash cow cart. The cash cow cart doesn't even come standard with all those things I just mentioned. So it's not that basic. So this is Imagination Apparel asked this question. Such things as four sinks, three sinks plus hand wash, can that be added to a cart? What inspired me to do this instead of just answering it was if you notice on the screen, the Think Blue right here, Think Blue put good luck getting a reply from Ben. And I'm like, holy heck, I spend 7 days a week answering emails and YouTube comments. And so I can only do so much. I even quit doing Facebook and installed that bot because 99% of the questions are the same, you know, or the same group of questions. And I create, you know, I put that Facebook bot on that would answer the questions. But these, I answer everybody's question as best I can. If I don't know, I'll tell you, hey, I don't know. But then I'll look it up for you. So anyway, it inspired me. Think Blue. Thank you. Inspired me to share it with you. So the first question was, such things as four sinks, can that be added? Well, yeah, it's actually our instructions for it. If you go to buildacart.com or you watch the video that I just showed just now, it has four sinks on it. So it's got the, you know, your hand wash and then your wash, rinse, sanitize. Also, my county has weird rules about the use of a commissary. The county wants daily records kept of the times I sign in and leave the commissary. Also, the county wants 10-gallon fresh water and 11.5-gallon gray water tank. So they're wanting, like, I don't know what that is. That's like a 15% larger gray water. That's pretty standard. 10-gallon is a pretty big tank for a cart, but we do it all the time. We have people request it, and we have to put it in. And it's just, instead of having the 5 and the 7, we go to a 10 and a 15. So in your case, 10 and 11 and a half. It's not a big deal. And you can double up your containers that we show you to put in the course. If you're wondering about the course, I put it in the comments. It's buildacart.com. Anyway, gray water tank should have four sinks. Yes, the county's regs are confusing, mixing statements about carts with statements about mobile food trucks. That happens a lot. Here in Tennessee, they have merged the food truck rules with the cart rules, but it, as far as it's all in the same group of rules, and you have to really be keen at reading legalese to figure out what they're talking about. What are you saying? And so that is a common one to have to deal with. Now, he's in Salt Lake City, Utah, or Salt Lake County, Utah, it says. Oh, Salt Lake City, yeah. If you noticed that he had a previous message right before it. So anyway, I wanted to answer this for him and talk about the things you can do. So what I did is I pulled up some things you can do. Okay, here is, and I want to make sure this is displaying. Okay, so you can see the screen. All right, so I'm going to try to go through this and show you a little bit about it. This is a vendor in California. California, the strictest state in the country for vending. Now, before I start that, I need to say this. COVID, you've probably heard of it, okay? Well, vendors this year have done better than I've ever in my history of vending, 12 plus years, ever have seen this much success with vending. Why? Well, most of them aren't doing events anymore where they used to make big money at events or traveling circuit events and stuff. They're now finding out they can do frontline workers, hospitals, because they closed the cafeterias. There's a blue million of opportunities. And now with restaurants closing for the second time, okay, it creates more opportunity. We've got vendors in our Vendors United group. We were talking about this last Monday, who are just driving into neighborhoods, subdivisions, and setting up, and people are going crazy, loving it. Okay, they come out, they serve safe. He's got, you know, they'll mark off stuff and tape off stuff so that people, you know, maintain the 6 foot distance rule and the mask. So just, it's brilliant to watch these vendors adapt to the changes and be rewarded so heftily. I think that's a word, heftily. Largely, bigly, there's a word. They get rewarded. So they take all that information that they just switched gears. We talked about this in March. We talked about it in April. And we were like, what do we do? What do we do? And we figured out ways. And when I say we, Vendors United, the vendors inside Vendors United are incredible. Okay. And so if you're a new vendor or not even started out yet, it's so much help. And so what happens is all these people are helping each other, plus they're learning stuff as they go, and they come up with little things that they do differently. Well, that's what's changed everything. Well, this vendor in California, okay, Eric Johnson, wanted to build his son or help his son build a cart from our course, the Build a Cart course. So if you just go to buildacart.com, you may hear me say that a couple times because we're going to be talking about it. So he says, okay, I'm gonna do it, but he wants to do everything. He's got a hidden cash drop safe. He's got speakers, lighting, a wastewater pump, literally a wastewater pump. So he doesn't even have to pull his wastewater out of the cart and go dump it. It pumps it out. It's just brilliant stuff this guy did. And we've had others do the same. We had a guy do one for his daughter that was incredible as well. But this guy went above and beyond. He kept sending me pictures. In all, he sent over 300 photos with a timeline of his build because he wanted to take my basic plans and extrapolate that into his creation, his idea, his invention. And he did it, and he met California's strict codes. And so you can see all that here. If you go over to the blog at learnhotdogs.com and you type in the word sexy cart, you'll see this title, Vendor Builds One Sexy Hot Dog Cart. And you can check that out. Not right now, though. Don't go yet. So which will take you to this article right here. Okay. This is everything in blue on this is his letter to me. Well, no, some of it's in black. So he goes through everything he did, unpacking the box, starting his framing, everything he did, he shows the pictures. Plus, I link you to, he goes even further. It's so incredible what this guy did for us. So it allowed other people to see that, hey, there's nothing stopping you. He's got a stereo system, a water system built out of half-inch copper pipe. He went even above the California codes. So, and here's what's so cool. Because he was so proud of this creation, which you can't blame him, he went and literally videoed live his inspection, his initial inspection. So you get to see his inspector show up and him walk through the whole cart. And the inspector is just in awe, just completely in awe. He's approved and starts vending. It was incredible. So anyway, If you know, we're seeing more and more people build carts now because it's just perfect timing. It's like, oh, I'm home anyway. My job's shut down right now or whatever. And they start building. If you're handy at all, you can do it. And we walk you through it. We've got a thing that walks you through every step. And it's not just words. It's videoed every single step. And if we use a skill saw, we show you with a handsaw too. And then we show you with a table saw. So that way, depending on what tools you have available to you, you don't feel like, oh crap, I ain't got a cross cutting miter saw or whatever. And so it's built out of wood. So if you see the cart, this cart right here, okay, is built out of wood. It has a stainless steel cap. That's it. Just a cap. That's cheap. Now, I've had some people go, you can't build that for $900. I just built mine, and it cost $1,600. And I go, well, send me a picture of it. I'd like to see a picture of it. One guy recently, this is back in April or May, sometime this year, though, he sent me a picture. Well, he sent me, like, several pictures. He had stainless the whole thing. He didn't have a stick of wood on it. He did solid stainless steel in a metal frame. Well, duh. We're showing you what you can do. You can literally do a wooden cart. Okay, it's legal in all states as long as it's non-porous, which means you put on whatever anti-porous material on top. So if you have, if you've ever been to a bar, especially in the South here, you go into these country barbecue joints. Most of the tables are just wooden tables that are clear coated, you know, with whatever that lacquer or now they call it resin, I think, resin all over it. And so that's non-porous. And so it's food safe, approved by the FDA. So anyway, if you build this, you'll be fine, but you want to find out your state's requirements. So if you built this cart in Florida, you'd want it with one sink, like it's shown right here, one sink on it, because Florida doesn't allow you to have more than one sink for whatever reason. Okay. It's just their thing. It's the only state that's like that. Then you have states like North Carolina and Tennessee that say, sinks, you ain't got to have no sinks on a cart. And so you could build it without the sinks and save even more money. So there's a lot to this. Now, Eric's dad Eric is the father. He sent over a link to all the photos. So I have more than this, but you can see this coming along here. It's an incredible, incredible deal. And I link you to the whole photo album of pictures here. This is some of them here. Okay. So just look at this. He walks you through, even when he was building out his trailer, the whole thing. He had solar power. Look at this, 5 pages of photos. I think it's actually more than that. Excuse me. And I even have more vendors that have done it too. Eric's just, I've never had anybody send me as many photos as he did. It was incredible. So let me go back over to here and put this back up. Look at it. It's getting dark. That's why my dang green screen ain't working as good. So no big deal. You don't even really need to see me as long as you can hear me, right? Okay, so Art makes a good comment here. Okay, I wanna share this, Art. Somehow. There's a way. You know, they've changed things again. It's like every time you turn on something, they've changed it. And it's like, oh yeah, we changed that. And you're like, what? Why would you change that? Let me go to my comment section here. Art, I think I got you now. I think I got you. There you go. So Art Makepeace says, only thing I'd say against Ben here, unless you know what you're doing, just buy a cart. It's much easier. Even find a used cart like I did. Abso-freaking-lutely. But how long does it take to build a cart? About a week if you're handy. If you were what somebody would consider a handyman. If you're like me, it might take you a couple weeks, okay? Because I need to see every step laid out. I need you to show me what a 2x4 is. And so I have to literally look at every detail before I can do it. And then I need to watch it twice, frontwards and backwards, slow motion. So yes, but we've had some incredible builds. Even women like, oh, surprise, women can hold a hammer. There's lots of females that have built carts. And then you have these MacGyvers, like Eric, that builds this NASA spaceship cart. So the cool thing is, too, is if you're going to buy a used one, if you got the course, you'd have everything you'd need to know how to repair anything or upgrade or adapt or anything. So it makes life easier. Or you may already know that stuff. And I don't know how dark I am, but let me flick on the light. How's that? That's better. I don't know how much better, but okay. So Let me go back up here in the comments, and I'll try to get to some of the comments here real quick. Howdy, Tasha. Howdy, Michael. Howdy, Big Dex. Keith is in the house. Tasha's in the house. Michael, thanks for being here. Okay, Yo Bennett just got Agri Supplies, a new location, making tons more sales than before. Okay, so this is Art Makepeace, okay, who had just had his stuff up just a second ago, right? And he says, Agri Supply. Absolutely. You know what people are doing this time of year? I say this time of year. What people are doing because of COVID, they're fixing their properties, they're building chicken pens, they're building donkey fences, they're doing all kinds of stuff. And people are doing gardening, so where are they going? We've got people in big cities, you know, they've had some news specials on, what are you doing to keep from being bored? Oh, I put a garden on my patio on my six-story apartment. You know, I'm on the sixth floor, and I have a little patio, and I put a garden. And so people are going to these Agri Supplies. They're going to these places to make money, but to set up there. But the people that are the customers are more than normal. So with things being closed, people are finding things to do. All right. Ryan asks, hey, Ben, do you ever have any free cart giveaway contests? Every year we give away carts. Last year we gave away four. We've given away two this year already. Typically it's in Vendors United. Last year I did two outside Vendors United and two inside Vendors United. So I typically find that here's why this sounds bad. It's not like, oh, you better join Vendors United or you won't have a chance to win. No. It's I don't care about that. What I care about is the people sometimes that win. It bugs me because it's random, right? You know, and so we take people that entered, put them in a CXL file, an XL file, right? And then it randomizes it. There's a little app you can get, and it randomizes, and it picks somebody. Well, when it picks somebody that is somebody that goes, oh, I just put my name in the hat and I'm going to just sell this sucker. And that's what some people have done. We had one win a Cater Pro that was loaded to heck up. I'm talking beautiful. I videoed him coming to the shop, picking up his brand new cart, everything. He never vended with it. He went home and sold it. It was on Craigslist within about 48 hours. I kid you not, because somebody in his area that's in our VU group goes, hey, that dude that won the cart's already selling it. And I went, dang, I was trying to help somebody. And that's the part that bugs me. So let's see. Hey, Ben, where's a good place to vend during the COVID virus? We've been talking a lot about this, Vince, in the VU group. There's tons of ways. I just mentioned one at the beginning of this, going into subdivisions. Vendors are making a killing at subdivisions. Vendors are making a killing at frontline places like your hospitals. I'll share one secret, okay? The most numbers I've seen this year at any single non-event, not like, oh, it's the Super Bowl and I made a lot of money. Well, of course you did, Super Bowl. I'm talking just at a normal location, that one location that I have heard and seen from vendors that are in our VU group that have made the most money are at these COVID testing sites where people are sitting in their cars for 3 and 4 hours waiting on test. And those are making a killing, but astronomical, like more than I ever made in a day vending, like just crazy freaking money, some of them. We've got vendors doing kettle corn at them, bringing it already bagged up. They did it in the garage, bagged up, so they don't have to deal with it there. Putting the cart beside it and doing fresh squeezed lemonade. You wouldn't believe what some are doing there. I've also got, if you're on my email list, if you're not, go to learnhotdogs.com. Something's going to pop up. Join that email list. It doesn't cost you anything. I'm fixing to announce something just freaking awesome and share a bunch of cool stuff. And not just VU, it's anyone that's on my email list is going to get it. But in the next few days, so you'll want to do that if you are on that. And then you'll want to whitelist it. Do you know what whitelisting is? It's when you, because sometimes my email may go in your spam because your email goes, oh, that's that hot dog, you know, Google goes, that's that hot dog guy, we're going to send that to spam. No, they just whitelist it because it's an unfamiliar email coming into your account. They don't know if you asked for it, so they just send it to spam. You never see it. You're going, Ben, I joined your list 9 times, and I ain't got your emails. And you go, oh, it's in spam. So check your spam and then put whitelist it, which there's different names on different platforms, but it's whitelist. It basically tells Google or Yahoo or whatever email service you're using, AOL, hey, this is somebody I want to receive from. Don't be shoving that in the trash. Bobby Clark, how you doing? Glad you're here. Tulsa, Oklahoma, Patty's in the house. Ryan, Big Dex, this is my first live chat. Awesome, Big Dex, I'm glad you're here. Jason in the house. Jason's in our VU group. Jason's out of Texas. He's got a Cater Pro cart that I was talking about a minute ago. Let's see. Oh, look, Brian Pierce in the house. Ben, Classic Kettle Corn here. That's the name of his company. Y'all should know him. I've talked about him, shared his stuff. You should be following people like this. This Saturday is our first event of the year. I've been punting this year. Yeah, it's scary, but here's the thing. So many vendors, like the one in the stuff that I'm sending out in the next few days, one of the vendors was doing this stuff at home with Kettle Corn and mailing it off locally, put it in a Facebook group and orders come in and then more orders come in, kind of like the banana bread lady, Miss Lindsay. So there's some freaking awesome stuff happening because people want some sense of normalcy. People need that. I need it. I need normalcy. I want to feel, you know, it's been trapped and now we're going to get retrapped basically in our homes. And so it's a great feeling to go somewhere where there's some type of normalcy. So when somebody knows, oh man, I ain't got to try to make my homemade bread tonight. I'm going to actually order from Brian Pierce. He's got hot dogs and kettle corn, and he'll send somebody Uber Eats or send one of his drivers over to get it. We've got vendors doing that. We've got vendors doing all kinds of foods, but one is doing casserole type stuff, lasagna casseroles and green bean casseroles, and doing these fridge meals that I've talked about on here before. We talk about it a lot more in the Vendors United group. Hint, hint. So you don't have to sit at home and wonder, oh, I wonder if that $600 a week payroll thing is going to end. I wonder if this is going to, it won't matter to you. Because the government can't sustain. It's not like they can just keep printing money. At some point, we have to go, okay, I gotta figure this crap out. It may mean a change in my life. It may mean a drastic change. But I'm not going to wait till the last minute where I'm picking up breadcrumbs off the floor. So you've got to, if now's the time, if you've lost your job or you want to change or you need to be in a safer environment, then change it. I'm not saying, oh, you got to commit to this for 10 years for it to work. No, you can start making money immediately. That's part of the reason I'm sending out this stuff in the next few days. Let's see. Taco Man is in house from, I always mess up. I butcher this, but I know the Massachusetts part. I can say that one. I don't know if that's Gloucester or Gloucester. I just don't know how to pronounce it. Look, Michael Wood says, get a day in the life too. Yeah, he's right. Michael did for us. He's one, not the oldest vendor. He's the longest time vendor, that I know personally. And he's been in VU since day one. He helps a blue million people. He helps people daily. He helps the new person to the person that's been vending 3 years and's got a new question. And Michael says, get the day in the life, because Michael has did videos for us so that we could share a whole day of him starting to finishing, closing down, going home, and putting stuff up. His wife filmed it. He did his normal day, and you get to see it. You can go to learnhotdogs.com/day and see that. Let's see. Let's see. Daniel says, hey, Ben, you want to ship me a free big dog cart to sponsor my Hot Dogging with Dan YouTube channel? You already have a, you're already doing good on your dang channel. You already have a cart. Mike, I appreciate it. My wife doesn't think I'm funny. Twice today, I told her things, and she didn't laugh. I had to explain it. And then she goes, oh, you didn't have to explain it. I got it. It just wasn't funny. So, let's see. I saw a guy with a reed shed on a flatbed selling sausage and chili. Unbelievable. That's awesome. That you wouldn't believe what some vendors are getting away with. Not like illegal or something crazy. I'm talking about going to Home Depot or Lowe's, and some of them are letting them in. The manager's like, yeah, yeah, I don't care. Just come. Heck with the company that manages vendors. Just come. And so there's a lot of great locations like the one I gave you from our VU group. Maybe Sober says waiting on paperwork before I start. We talked about that the other day because, like, what happens if it's going to be 3 months? Like, there's some health departments that are so low staffed, they've moved staff to help with COVID, that they have nobody inspecting restaurants, and most of the restaurants are closed, so they ain't got nobody to inspect your hot dog cart. And so we've got vendors starting without them. But I tell you what to do to make that as legit as possible. Get a business license, your tax number. Okay. Both those are cheap and easy. Okay. And your third, take a food safety course from ServSafe or another accredited course online. Get that certification, laminate it, and stick that sucker to the side of your cart or your table or your whatever, your trailer and your reed tent. Let's see, King David in the house, Buzz. Fine, greetings from Southwest Florida. Let's see, Brian, I can't believe I have let this COVID thing shut me down as long as I have. People are so excited to see me popping. Brian, you're exactly right, but there is nothing wrong with playing it safe. I am not. Did y'all see Herman Cain today? Passed away from what? COVID. He's been saying the whole time, I ain't wearing a mask, I ain't wearing a mask. And what did he do? He went to that thing. They believe that's where he caught it, that the rally that was it Arkansas or Oklahoma? I think it was Arkansas. And did that rally, and they believe he caught it there because 9 days later he has COVID. And now he's passed away today. And it's sad. It's sad that that happened. I'd rather you be safe than sorry. Even if you don't stand a chance of getting it, be safe. Be safe and be safe for others. And just I'd rather err to the side of caution. You know, it doesn't bother me to wear a mask. I don't really like it, but it doesn't bother me. It's like wearing a seatbelt. It took me a while to get used to that too. Cause that wasn't a law. And then it became a federal law. So, Ricky Nixon says, Ben, Ricky's in VU. He's building a cart, from the course. It's almost done. See, you can see this stuff for you're in VU. You'd see that. And if he shares it with me and has pictures and stuff, I'll, and allows me to share it elsewhere, I will. You can see one coming along. Art says that he's talking about what he talked about a minute ago about the Agri Supply. Looks like a freaking Wally World. I've been set up there 2 days last week and yesterday, and today this week I'm making 3 times the sales of my old location. And that's what I'm talking about. Vendors are making more money than ever. I have never, I promise you every day, I at least get one call from a vendor. And I'm not talking about emails and stuff because I get those too. But I'm saying at least one call a day from a vendor who is on cloud 9 because they just feel like they won the lottery. It is happening every single day. And I've never had a year like that. I've never seen it like that. This is an incredible opportunity and time to be vending. Let's see, Oblio, you can always watch what you missed. I talked about building a car. I've talked about, you know how me, I sidetrack every which way. Jason says, love my Cater Pro. Thanks, Jason. Sean is in the house. Andre, hey, Ben, know any vendors in San Diego? I believe so. We used to keep a list of vendors everywhere, and then we'd put that online if they allowed us to. So they only got on the list if they allowed us to put it online. So that way people that were just getting started or whatever could contact them. Well, that turned into a freaking nightmare. And vendors complained and dropped off the list because people were just showing up. People would hang out all day. People would interrupt their business, and they didn't like it. So what I did is I talked to a few of my friends that are vendors into letting you come to them and spend a day for free. It doesn't cost you a dime other than your travel to get to them, and go spend a day with them and vend and learn. And so that you can find at learnhotdogs.com/best day ever. Best day ever. And that will give you an opportunity to do that. The only other thing I'd suggest, if you get in VU, you're going to find vendors all over the country, all over the world. That's a great place, too, to talk to them and get to know them, because most vendors are a little standoffish to just putting their name out there to everybody going, hey, I'm down here on 5th and Main in Wetumpka, Alabama. Come on, see me. They ain't going to do it. Lamar, aloha. I got mine at a masonry and brick company. Trump money is doing great with everything, doing home repairs. Awesome. Hey, Ben, know any vendors? Okay, I got that one. Awesome. Art, awesome. I'm reading comments, so bear with me. Ricky says, I have all the paid courses. That's probably overkill, Ricky. Probably overkill. Okay, somebody told me how to pronounce it. Glue Alchester. I'll take your word for it. It doesn't sound right in my head. I have a hot dog stand in Augusta, Georgia. Best thing ever. Marie. Awesome, Marie. Congratulations. Michael Woods in the house. He's from Georgia. And Vin's there in a little bitty town. And he's had the best year he's ever had. In over 10 years, which he's been in over 10 years, he's never had a better year. It's incredible. Let's see. Is there two versions of Day in the Life? There kind of is. There's Michael Woods Day in the Life, and that's just learnhotdogs.com/day. And then there's Best Day Ever, which is where you just go to sign up to go with one of the vendors for a day that have allowed me to, you know, tell you. So there's no cost though on that. Go spend a day with them. Let's see. Scott says, hi, Ben. I've been watching your videos last month, thinking about taking the plunge, jumping into the hot dog business, have the usual nerves. Everyone else does. Thanks for sharing all the info. Absolutely, Scott. It is normal to have the nerves. But the point is it really, if you're not in a position where you have to do it, that's great. So just do it part-time. If you don't like it, the cool thing about this business is, especially this time of year and in the spring, carts sell for more than they cost new. Used carts, go to our used cart page, you'll see. There's people selling, because we just let anybody list their cart there. There's people selling carts there that are cost more than a new than it did new. Why? Why would anybody pay that? Because it's right there right now. If you order for me, you might be 2 weeks out, okay, to get your cart by the time it gets to you and shipping and everything. So people go, oh, I found it on hotdogcartsforsale.com page, and they just buy it because it's right now. Yeah, I paid $800 more than a new one, but I needed it. So they just start. So you can start at any point and start part-time, but you can always sell it if you don't like it, because it's not for everybody. There's people that simply just, you know, I don't want to be a person that changes light bulbs on radio towers. That is not my cup of tea. Don't really care how much money's in it. It ain't my cup of tea. So this may not be your cup of tea. Look at there. Robert says, everything Ben is telling you I did last week, I am waiting on that hot dog, or the health department started with lemonade. Awesome, Robert Brown. Keep me up to date on what's going on with that. This is a great point by Mike, And I've talked about this before, and I'm glad, Mike, thank you for bringing this up, because it's a good point. Did you know here in Massachusetts, you do ServSafe course in person? Guess what? All 50 states, it's in person. It's only, there are some states that allow some other courses online, but typically, well, all the time, ServSafe was in person. Now they're allowing online courses, and you can get it for free, too. So it's a win-win-win, and I think it's awesome that they would even do that. That's their business. That's their income, and ServSafe is saying, hey, to help people out, we're going to let them get ServSafe certified for free. Just come on over here. Get your COVID certificate. Get whatever they have for free. Go ahead and take the test. Get it. Print it. Get it laminated. Stick it on the side of your cart. And then if the health department happened to show up, you'd go, look, I did this, this, and this. I know y'all couldn't get to me, but at least I did these things. I have my business license, have this, have my insurance. I'm ready to go. The odds, I haven't heard of one vendor getting in trouble yet or even being stopped. So in those areas where the health department can't get to them, where they're telling them, hey, we can't get to you this year. That's literally what they're telling some of them. Hey, we can't get to you this year. We can't even inspect you. Okay. I'm going to go out on my own then. I ain't going to say that to them, but I am. maybe Sober says my second card to be one of yours. Listen, it doesn't matter. I appreciate it, but it doesn't matter. There's a lot of good cart manufacturers. I say a lot. There's a few good cart manufacturers. And so you get the best deal you can. And I always push people to get used, because sometimes, like in the winter, you can buy carts cheap. If you wait for the right opportunity, you can buy them cheap. Look here. Here's Michael Wood. He's in Georgia in a little bitty town. Okay. I'm feeding 180 teachers and staff tomorrow on a private catering gig. Okay. That's why he's part-time vending, but makes a full-time income. Okay. And here's how I can say that. One, I know him personally, and trust him and love him. And he is nothing but helpful to everyone that he comes across. He is a huge asset to vendors in our VU group. And he's been doing it a long time. And what is the average income in America right now? 30,000 or something. You can make more than that doing this part-time. Look at that. Art got a 99 on his inspection in Wake County, North Carolina. And I know Wake County, North Carolina, and they do have one inspector strict as crap. They'll dock you if your shoelace is untied. I have your book. I have a cart, and I'm getting my ducks in a row. I got vending, in Connecticut. I'm super excited and nervous. Kristen, I'm super and excited and nervous. Typical. I actually have a video on it's basically, oh crap, I got a cart, now what? About being nervous as a long tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs, scared to go do it. And it is, but once you do it and you realize that nobody around you knows that the way you're doing it ain't the right way, as far as they see it as, that guy's a vendor, must be the right way. And so it doesn't matter if you screw up, they wouldn't notice. No, I mean, you drop the hot dog in the dirt and then try to feed it to them. That'd be different. But yes, I have seen the movie Perfect Storm, Mike. That was a great movie. I have a cart and I'm getting my ducks in a row. Let's see. Casey, Ben, watching your videos, getting stuff together slowly. Booked my first gig next weekend. Congratulations, Casey. 2-day motocross race, starting with a tent and some tables. Would be lying if I said I wasn't nervous. I need to talk about nervous. Maybe I'll come on tomorrow and redo a nervous video. Cause, if you just YouTube on my YouTube channel, you know, if you just do in the search box on the videos, just put in the word nervous or scared and it should pull it up, but it is not uncommon. I was scared as crap. But once I got doing it and talking to people, it just was like, oh, this ain't bad. It's fun. And it ends up, it gets better and better, more fun, funner and funner. Okay. Ben P in the house. Glad you're here. Bill Muncy been going now for 3 weeks, crushing it in Colorado Springs during old man softball games today. Secured a permanent spot at Sportsman's Warehouse. Hey, if y'all aren't seeing all the comments, I know what's happening here. If you're not seeing all the comments, because my screen pulls the comments from Facebook and YouTube, so I'm seeing them both. And you're seeing whichever platform you're on, so you may be thinking, that Ben's making up comments because I didn't see that. But here's a good example. Like this, I believe, is from YouTube, I believe. Okay. This one, I can tell, is from Facebook because they always put the picture. I have to do it, but trying to hold out till it starts to get cool. Here in Arizona, 118 today. Yeah, Eddie, I was in Surprise, Arizona with my wife and filmed a vendor. This has been years ago. I filmed it live and put it on YouTube. And her name was Jackie, and she was in front of a Home Depot in Surprise, Arizona, and she had one of these monstrosity of a, what is it called? Swamp. We call them swamp coolers. So it was an evaporative cooler right there in the parking lot running off of a generator. It was cool as crap. And so right around her cart, even in that hot asphalt, and she didn't have tents set up, which blew my mind, but she wanted visibility, so she didn't want tents. And she had, it was pretty cool. It was pretty decent. If you stood near that where it was blowing, it felt pretty good. Jamie Coyne in the house. Glad you're here, Jamie. Greg Grafton, how you doing, Greg? Greg's in VU. Jamie's in VU. Greg's in, Virginia. And, Jamie is in Ohio, I believe. I could be mistaken. I have CRS sometimes. I love that honesty, ready to help people to start with a used cart and not one of your own. Yeah, it doesn't, Art, I've just always, if you're going to help people, be honest with them, and that's honest. You can't honestly, you can halfway help people, then you're just half-assing, and I don't want to half-ass. I want to give people 100% support, love, and tell them to do this. So, it's why I tell people, look, there's no ads running across the screen. My live stream is not being interrupted with ads. You know why? Because I opted out. Even though I'm a partner with Facebook or YouTube and could do that, I don't choose to do that because I want you to get the meat, right? And yes, I sell courses and yes, I sell carts. But either way, if you end up, let's say you want a course from me, I'll put money on every single course I have, every single course. All the information, every bit of the information is in the blog for free. Now, it takes finding it and watching this video or doing this and digging through all the thousands of articles and videos there. But it doesn't matter. It's free, right? And so I create the courses to make it like more compact. Here I took the time to do this, put it all right here. You can get it here for $7 or you can go over here and get it for free. Let's see. Look at this, Malaysia. That is cool as crap. I'm gonna say Mukris. I'm not even gonna try the last name. I apologize. It's the hillbilly in me. We're not good at pronunciations. Or at least this one ain't. So I'm glad you're here, though. That's freaking awesome. I've worked 50 days this year. There you go. Michael Wood, 50 days this year. Guess what? If you worked full-time as a vendor, what your average would be, though, in a 365-day calendar year? Your average would probably be, or at least I know what the average is in our vendors, okay, is somewhere around 200 days a year. That's 165 days off a year, okay? Michael just told you, now he makes full-time income, but he works part-time in a small town in Georgia, been doing it for a long time, knows the ropes. And Michael worked 50 days this year. There you go. And he's also one of these people that knows every dime to the tenth of a penny. He knows what his cost is on everything. He watches everything. He's good at that. He helps a lot of people with that as well. Vinyl graphics, Kristen. Here's my suggestion. Keith, if he's here in the group, hopefully he will, or watching this, he can message you. He would know where to get, he may have somebody local to him in Ohio that could get it done, or he could get it done. I don't think he does vinyl graphics, but he does. He has somebody that is a partner that does it. I know that you can typically go online and go to a car graphics company or just a vinyl graphics company and request something. Some of them let you build it on their website, and then you just get it in sheets. It's easy to install. Most of them won't tell you this. Use Windex and spray the cart or your car or your truck or whatever you're vinyling. Spray it with it and then stick the sticker on or the vinyl sheet. That way you can move it around and move air bubbles easily. And then that Windex dries and it doesn't hurt the glue. And now you're stuck, but you didn't have to worry about putting it on and then trying to move it. It doesn't move when you just stick it on dry. Just a little tip there. Look here. Here's Dwayne Dogg says, Michael Woods has been such a blessing and helpful every time I've asked him. Thank you, Michael. Dwayne, Divine Dogs and Catering. Absolutely. Thank you, Dwayne. Art says he's got a swamp cooler by him in Arizona. Let's see. When I started hot dog vending the American style on the street, people are skeptical. No one does it here and was super nervous, but I came over that by watching and getting motivated by you. Thank you a ton for that. It was, believe it or not, it was the same way for me in East Tennessee to start vending. I literally had, my wife and I had people pulling over to find out what this thing is. They had never seen this contraption before. And it's steam coming out of it. It was an eye candy for them. And they were like, oh my gosh, we got to turn around and see what that is. That ain't no shucker machine. That's something new. That's some new fandangle thing out of New York or something. And people just stopped just to see what it was and then buy a hot dog. So it was, it definitely worked as a marketing tool as well. Okay, Michael says, just 350 hours in 7 months and 50 days. I told you he kept records down to the penny. So he's worked 350 hours in 7 months, okay, and over a period of 50 days. Art made peace. If people don't know what a swamp cooler is, look it up on YouTube. Yeah, they're pretty cool. After 7 years of venting at festivals, I still get excited, nervous. You should have seen me the first time we vented the side of the road. Absolutely, Brian, I am with you. I was scared. I literally, long tail cat room full of rocking chairs scared. It was nerve wracking, stomach hurting. Oh my gosh. What if I have to go to the bathroom? What if? And that's why I have those top 40 new vendor question and answers because it's, I think if you're human, if you're breathing, you probably got nervous the first few times. And so I get it completely. Howdy, Matthew from Oklahoma, Panhandle. I sling weenies 3 hours a day. I make more in those 3 hours than a 10-hour day at a full-timer. Turned in my notice for full-timer last week. Congratulations, Bill. Okay? Now, I'm not sitting here telling you. I'm not talking to you, Bill. I'm talking to others. Hey, quit your job. You know, give them the thumb. You know, don't be singing Johnny Paycheck to them. Take this job and trip it. Don't do that and just run off. Okay, and leave it. Do it smart. Do it like you would anything else. Take your time. Do your due diligence. You can get all that stuff done quickly and start vending, maybe part-time. Maybe you go, hey, my full-time job, I'm going to, like he did, you know, do it part-time and then do it full-time. And you can do that quick. It may take you two times out, and you're like, see ya, boss. Let's see. When I join VU, how can I get the mafia discounts? My husband said to join both. Yeah, you want to join the, cause they're two different, complete different things. But the VU, once you join VU, you can get the mafia for half off. So that's just a little tip. You also get like insurance from it's the highest amount of insurance you can get, 2 million coverage for a vendor, plus a 10,000 bonus policy. Like if you're cart flipped over, somebody stole it or something, for less than anyone else in the world. How about that? Through VU. Nobody else can do it. Ben is the godfather of modern vending, a catalyst for why people make it in this business. I thank you for that. I think you have people that either are a magnet to this type of business, being an entrepreneur, and they make it work. They're the ones that make it work, like you. You make it work. You might get some information from me, but you're the one doing it. You're the one that has to get up and go out there and sling weenies or whatever you're serving, or banana bread like Miss Lindsay or whatever it is. You're the one doing it. So I thank you for the kind words, but you got to give credit where credit's due, and that money's coming because of you. Clint says, I'm in Guilford County, North Carolina, and want to buy a cart and sell hot dogs. I don't know where Guilford County is. It's got to be over on the western side. Eastern side. But either way, it doesn't matter. I just can't place it in my head. Do you think I can hire someone to run it and still make it? Yes and no. Here's the deal. I would, if I was going to start a cart just for somebody else to run, I would want to get it set up and get it running with them, maybe have them with me, and so that you knew what to expect of them. Because the only way to really know what to expect is to do it. And even if it's not a lot, even if it's for a day or two, you've kind of got an idea what to expect. Now, the vendors in VU will give you lots of tips on that, because we have vendors with multiple carts and employees or subcontractors doing it as well. I wouldn't probably suggest, hey, I'm going to just get a cart and just hire somebody to run it. I will tell you this, Clint, is you can, and I know my videos go on and on and on, but I haven't been live since the 7th. Okay. So I'm making up for it. So I apologize if you get bored with my long videos. Anyway, so Clint, what I would do is, before you buy a cart, advertise that you have a licensed cart for rent, a licensed hot dog cart or mini mobile catering cart, whatever you want to call it. Because a cart is really a mini mobile kitchen. So a lot of people are using them for catering, and a lot of people are using them on the street very rarely, but more catering and gigs like Michael Wood doing the teacher's deal. That's a private deal. Get paid and done, and you're guaranteed the amount, and you just leave, right? So if you advertise that you have a cart, we have some vendors that are taking those carts and they're advertising that. And I'm telling you to advertise it, not as false advertising, to get a feel for the area, to see if somebody's out there. There's people out there that want to rent a cart, a licensed, ready to go cart. Okay. And then you can take their name and number and go, look, I don't have that one right now, but I'm fixing to have another one. Or this one I got delayed on, but as soon as I do, I'll call you back. But they're making $75 to $150 a day renting them. Did you hear what I said, Clint? So now you're not responsible for whether it makes money or not. If they've done their due diligence and they are a responsible person that doesn't need to, you know, stay in bed all day and sleep past noon, then they can go out from 11 to 1 or 2 every day and make more than enough to get started. There's a lot of people I would have done that in a New York second. I'd have paid $150 a day to rent a cart when I got started, because it took me longer because I had to build up to buy a cart. And that was like an obstacle. I couldn't even see the top of that mountain. So it took a while for me to get there. You're providing an opportunity and a business opportunity to get started today. That's where some vendors in our VU group are making a killing with that side stuff. They'll buy every used cart that comes along and license it and put it out there for rent. We've got people that rent them to families coming in for vacation. Right here locally, people come into vacation, they going up in the mountain, stay in the park for a day and have a family reunion or whatever, and they rent the cart for the day. Ben P just got a swooper flag. Congratulations. Swooper flag will make a big difference, Ben. Sasha, could I make it in a town of only 3,000 population? Sasha, let me answer this real quick. And then I want you to do your homework on this a little bit and go look where I interviewed this lady and the whole deal. Globe, Arizona. Podunky town. Okay. And I'm sure some of y'all in Arizona know what I'm talking about. Globe, Arizona, this lady was like, oh my gosh, I'm never going to make it here. This won't do it. Ben, will it do it? She ordered the cart before I had ever talked to her. Then she calls me and she's panicked. I think I made a wrong decision. What do I do? And this has been several years back. And now she has two carts in the same town. So here's how you answer that question, Sasha. Here's my quickest, easiest answer. How many gas stations do you have? How many grocery stores? How many convenience stores in your small town? How are they able to stay open? So a hot dog cart, you're going to be a hit. You're going to be a hit and a half. Michael Wood will tell you. So definitely, small towns are awesome. I love small towns better than big towns. You'll do better. Let's see. Is it still a good time to get started now? DJ, I'm a little biased, but I can tell you this. I've never seen vendors make more money than now, ever. This is an opportunity to make gobs of money. I would still, don't rush into it. Don't be like, well, I'm going to buy a cart tonight. I don't even know what my rules are. I'm going to just get one. No, follow my steps. It's free. LearnHotDogs.com. Click the start thing and go through those steps. Do it the right way so that you're protected. Your investment of time and money is protected. And get started. But you can make all that happen in a matter of days. So it's not like, oh, I got to go through 3 years of training and then I got to work under somebody for a while. No, it's none of that crap. But you can do it. I would say the best time to plant a tree is 20 years ago or today. So same goes for vending. Get started. Never put it off. You can procrastinate. But it just never happens. And you know, how do you keep good records of cost and income? I just got started a couple of weeks ago and I don't have a good way to keep track. Shauna, you're going to love my way. Maybe Michael Wood like kind of gags every time he hears my way. But I show you step by step my way. It's free. There's nothing to buy. LearnHotDogs.com. Okay. On the right hand side of the screen, if you're on a computer, if you're on a phone, I think you have to click those three bars and click the search. But anyway, on the right-hand side of the screen, click on the search box and type in records or record, and that's for record keeping. And you're going to see my way and other vendors' ways. My way is super simple, super simple. Could I do vending part-time nights like Friday and Saturday nights? I was looking into buying a food vending truck to go to multiple stops. Yes, you can do it part-time. We have some people that only do it two nights a month, two days or two nights a month, whatever. You definitely can, Jeff. It's a great question. Thanks for the question. I don't know why that didn't show up till just now, but there you go. Michael says there's free spreadsheets on VU. Even Michael's spreadsheet for keeping up with your records easily is on VU. Been doing my research to start a hot dog cart. Does size of town make a difference? About 20,000 southwest of Kansas. Matthew, hopefully you were listening to me just a minute ago when I was sharing with Sasha. Absolutely. Absolutely, Matthew. 20,000, you could probably have 10 carts running, okay, and have some competitors. It just, how many, put it into regular terms. How many customers do you think you need to have a big day? 60? 80, 100. I always sought 100 because I was selling it cheap. I was selling $5 meals, two dogs, drink, chips, $5, right? But I was still making, I was right at a 33% cost ratio. So I was making 66% profit, okay? Plus my time, I break it all down for you, but it's on the blog for free. But anyway, I saw it for 100. Well, 100 at five is $500 freaking dollars for 2 hours of work. So how many people are in your town? 20,000? You ain't gonna serve 1,000 of them. You ain't gonna serve 500 of them. So if you're just set up somewhere, you'll probably get 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Now we do have some vendors that are in small towns. Like if you follow Daddy-O's Cheesesteaks, he's in a small town. I'm sure he does. His average day is probably 200-300 people. Okay. Cause they love him and they go where he goes. He goes to the next small town. They're there. They're following from this small town to that small town. Mike says, I'm getting a tan. No, it's the freaking color. I had to change the color to get the green screen to work earlier. So it messed with the color of my face. I don't have a tan at all. Let's see. Yeah, Oblio, you're right. It's about half off. I think it's right at half off. In the VU group. Hey, Ben, have you been using your advice in high school band? Because I stand it has helped a lot. Makes me want to jump right in thinking of a retirement job. Okay. I've been using your advice on our high school band concession stand. Eugene, that's freaking awesome. We have some churches that have bought carts. We have some fundraising or community charities that have bought carts that have done, that do well as far as they set them up to do what they, to make money for their cause. And it's a brilliant way to do it. It's why I teach to even link your own business to one of these charities to help them out, but also help you get your name out and stuff. Thanks, Jeff. Appreciate your kind comment. I see a guy on YouTube that says you can rent a cart from someone. Yeah, there's some people renting them, DJ, but it's not all the time. It is a good idea. If you can't afford one, it's a great way to start. If you're unsure if you're going to like the business, another great way to start, because it's very little commitment. And it depends on what they're offering. Are they giving you a location and are they giving you a licensed cart? That's even better. And that's what I did, and that's what many vendors do. They go, hey, you can go to any location you want, but I got a location over here with this cart, and it's got a license, so you're ready to go. I really wouldn't want to rent them without a license because then it could come back to me, on me. For the people I know also have a really great CPA, absolutely, Michael. Hey, Ben, Southern Dogs in the house. Thanks, Tim. Glad you're here. Let's see. Okay, there you go. So Michael says in 2000, the census states his town is 5813. So that's probably his whole county. Hey, guys, a lot of sports bars can't open because of COVID. They need to pay the property rent, asked to use their kitchen and trade to sell outside the property to have a commercial kitchen as well. Absolutely. And Mike, we've had some vendors actually link up with the restaurant so that the restaurant was basically renting their cart to be the outside vending of the restaurant. So the restaurant still cooked it. It got brought outside, put in the cart, and handed out to customers or sold to customers or spooned out or ladled out or whatever the heck they were selling. Come and go, and as a gas station here, they normally have hot dogs on the roller grill. Doesn't matter. Due to COVID, they can't sell them. I started sitting in the lot next to them and getting a lot of their lunch traffic. I bet you did, Bill. That was brilliant. Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. I'm a nomad. You have to have a cart license in each state and festival I attend. Okay, imagination. I hope you caught this at the beginning because I answered your question. This video was for you, imagination. So you're asking another question that I have an answer for. I'm probably not going to go into it here, but yes and no. Okay, so the answer is yes. You do have to have a cart license, but if you're just doing festivals, probably not. Just one license, your state, your home state, and then you can go to festivals. We've got vendors doing that. But let me tell you where to go to get the whole kit and caboodle of this information for free. LearnHotDogs.com, okay? And just put in the word state or across state lines in the search box, and you'll pull it up. Been working overtime. Absolutely. Colleges have to. High school football games. Let's see. I am building my cart. I see my cart around 800 on Amazon. Is that a good deal? I seen a cart for around 800 on Amazon. Let me tell you, if you're talking about that little red thing that with the looks like bicycle wheels and it's kind of a replica looking of an old push cart, a tinier version of it, you will be completely pissed off because we've had some vendors get them. Even some of our vendors with carts have got them to do like a catering gig and thought they were getting they're a pain in the neck, and you will not be happy with it. From all the experiences of others, I've never owned one. I have seen one, touched one, but I wouldn't, do that. No. Howdy, Jeff. Is it cheaper to build? Absolutely. It's cheaper to build a cart. You can build a whole cart like the one I pictured, for less than 900 still to this day. We've had it happen in July this month. I've had people send me pictures of their completed cart and tell me, Ben, I finished it at 11:42, or the one I told you about that was mad, cause, or he tried to, I don't know if he was mad. He was kind of being a jerk, but he said, $1,600 it took me to build it. You said 900. You stainless steeled the whole freaking thing. That's different. That ain't apples and apples. Okay. Wow. I have been on here a long time. I hope you got some meat out of this, and that you'll take it, and hopefully it inspired you to do something. Get on my freaking email list, and you are going to love, even if you get off in a few days, you're going to love what's coming. I'm doing some cool stuff. So anyway, that's how I reach everybody. That's how I told people that I was going live, email and text messages. So thank you for being here. I love you. You can do what you want. You can change your life. You don't have to be a victim to this situation economically. Okay. I do want you to remember to be safe and remember others, be courteous and kind. Don't take advantage of people and do it the right way. Do it the right way to the best of your extent, you know, or your capabilities or the opportunity available. You're welcome, Mike. Thank you. Art, we do need to do an interview video. That'd be awesome. I love doing interview videos. Robert, thank you. I appreciate it. Y'all have a good one. Talk to you soon. Bye.